Good for fucking Case Keenum getting the bag.
He got $20 million to do exactly what Trevor Siemian was doing as a fucking 7th.
I don't know. Pick. I think it's a QB controversy in Cleveland.
Who's the other quarterback there?
Baker Mayfield.
No, who's the other quarterback?
Oh, Case Keenum.
Case Keenum.
Oh, that's right. Yeah,
3 years,
right.
$18 million.
Just snagged him up.
That's QB money, $18 million.
Dude, comes not per year. Back with Stefanski.
The stars are aligning.
No. Baker had a pretty bad year.
I'm just
year.
Saying, like, do you guys honestly do
new
you,
regime?
Do you feel this way, like, confident? Like, I confidently feel that if I was running the Broncos, like organization, like I was making the picks, I think we would be in a better spot today.
No. I confidently feel that you would not have put the Broncos in a better position.
These people know so much more. We think they're all idiots.
Yeah, but why didn't?
Bill O'Brien's the one we could definitely say is an actual idiot.
Yeah, that's obvious.
But a lot of puzzling moves that we think are puzzling, it probably turns out better.
Yeah, but like I'm telling you, Lael Collins, when the Cowboys picked him, I would have taken him in the fucking fourth round, the third round.
But I'm sure there's like also like 17 guys that you love that got taken and ended up being terrible.
No, that's not true. Everybody I wanted was a stud. My first round draft picks were all studs. Every first round pick I wanted was a stud.
Okay.
Turned out to be a stud. Ryan Ramczyk, stud.
Who'd you want this past year?
Yeah, I'm actually curious. You guys traded back, I remember.
Oh, I wanted Devin Bush.
Noah Fant.
Middle linebacker.
Devin Bush is stud.
Yeah, and we traded with the Steelers.
You shouldn't have made that trade.
We traded with the Steelers who took him. It worked out because we did get Dalton Risner, who was another guy I really wanted. So it worked out.
And you got Noah Fant.
Yeah, Noah Fant I think will be okay. I wasn't really...
Devin Bush is fucking monster, though.
You hated Fant.
I did hate it at first. I still don't really like it because tight ends in the first round...
Honestly, outside of that 174-yard catch and run, I don't know if Fant was any good.
Like, I know like you have to take him there, but like I just don't like the value of getting a tight end in the first round. I don't think it ever pays off.
No. Especially when you draft one at 8.
Yeah, well, we didn't draft him at 8.
I know.
The Lions.
The Lions did.
Yeah.
And he might be retiring soon, so.
Yeah?
I don't know. He had like 24 concussions last year.
Yeah, I'm glad I got him off my team. Yeah. Glad I got the new tight end one in fantasy, Hayden Hurst, the god.
Yeah, that's another guy. That's a perfect example. Like, that was a first-round tight end.
Well, the Ravens drafted 4 first-round tight ends.
Yes, but he came in the league and
first,
did shit.
First, second, third, and overall, fourth overall picks were all tight ends.
Yes, I know.
They kept trading up.
Uh-huh. Funny.
All right, you guys ready?
Yeah, let's start this fucking thing. What's cracking, big dogs?
Run it.
That was it.
Run it.
I just ran
you
it.
You usually cut me off for the intro when you do that.
I know, but I saw you go, like you were going to say something.
Well, I was going to let you go with it now that you started it. People are going to talk shit about the bottom of my socks. Are you still hurting from the car crash?
I'm still banged up.
I feel great. I actually feel better. I think she fixed my back.
Yeah.
I know you are not... Though your back and neck
so
are
hurting.
So to fix
it, he should get into another accident?
I'd say so, yeah.
This time from the front, so I go that way.
Ooh, I think we might be honest. Next thing you know, we're just getting in fucking 32 accidents a month.
Wait, hold on, time out real quick. I'm sorry, again. Go. Is that a bad omen that we get literally rear-ended coming to
my
new
back
HQ?
Gets corrected? No, I think it's a wonderful thing. No.
I think it was more of
on our way. Is it a bad omen or is it
not
like
for the HQ?
A-
I think maybe that was it was a way of saying like, don't go... into the city, and it was like basically it was letting you know
it was a warning.
We shouldn't have went to the city that day.
It was a warning sign. You're right. We should have turned back.
That's when we should have been like, you know what? Maybe we don't go into the city today.
Fuck, we didn't really think that through. We just wanted to get there.
Yeah, I just said I was like, this is a fine piece of German automobile. We'll make it.
I've been back to the apartment like twice since then, and every time it gets cooler, and I'm really fucking excited for it.
I know. I had a dream about it the other night.
Really? Mm-hmm. I think it was. I got 5 keys.
We had a hammock in there.
Yeah, I'm bringing my air mattress next week. I have a slumber party.
Yeah, we're building the table. We went to Home Depot earlier today.
This weekend or next?
Next.
Next
FTP.
We're going to film Tuesday. He's going to come back with me to Manhattan Tuesday night.
Okay.
Sleep there and build it like that night. And then the next day, we're going to do it too.
Okay.
Because by Monday, come Sunday or Monday.
So next week, not weekend.
Yeah, whatever.
Come Sunday, I'll have everything moved in there pretty much. And I'll probably be in the place.
Are we brunching that day? Oh, we're not going to be allowed out anymore.
Probably not. Yeah.
Well, we get brunch at the fucking
quarters.
Let's
just
make
our
own brunch.
We'll get it to,
You guys want to do that?
Yeah.
I think the roof is closed. I got a fucking email saying all community areas are closed until further
notice. Maybe we push it back then.
Yeah. It's all right. No, dude, it'd actually be fun to do that.
That
to,
would be a
to
good
christen
time.
The place.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like food.
Okay. Okay.
Enough I'll take the mimosas. Anyway.
What's cracking, big dogs? Welcome, Bike, to the contaminated dungeon for one. This isn't the last time, right?
Second to last.
No.
Second or third to last. I don't know.
We got to see with construction.
Yeah. But this is.
We're closing up shop soon.
We are closing up shop. It's kind of sad.
It's very sad.
It is really sad.
What's cracking, big dogs? Welcome back to the channel. It's a different HQ than we're normally at, but this is the first official E-Town Get Down weekly recap.
You set me up for this. Yes. You are sadistic fucking assholes.
Yes.
Dude, I've been crying a lot lately.
I'll tell you what, man. I missed you guys.
Ah!
Whoa!
He traded Mahomes?
Yeah.
He offered me Mahomes. I said
what
no.
What the fuck for a fifth, a third, six, and a fifth?
I'm actually cleaning this place tomorrow, believe it or not. No. It's in the calendar.
You have to wait until we leave to clean it.
It's in the calendar. It has to get done.
He's going to clean it when we still have fucking film to do.
Well, just like that area. So this part I'll leave.
Okay. Nothing on camera gets cleaned.
Yeah, no. We'll leave the dirtiness.
Keep the shit filled. My favorite part about this is taking the selfies and having the fingerprints all over the mirror. There's always new people getting mad about it.
There's always a message like, wipe your mirror.
Maybe you'll get what's in there if you clean your mirror. Like, probably also not, though. I don't think she knows about the fucking mirror. We're talking free agency today, baby. We're talking free agency. We're going to dip into the new CBA, what it means for fantasy, what it means for life, what it means for... you know what? Like, this is just such a weird time in life right now because everything is getting locked down. So we hope that with no sports on the television or
try to normalize
YouTube. Yeah, we hope that we can bring you guys some entertainment during these hectic and odd instances in our life. This is the only time in our life we're probably going to go through something like this.
I would hope so.
I hope not.
If we make it out,
I'm all in.
I'm excited for the next one.
Because I was built for this shit. While everybody else is fucking scrambling and they don't know what to do all day, they're like, oh, I'm so bored being here for 2 days. I was like, bitch, I've been doing this for 3 fucking years.
Yeah, that's
enough. So fuck y'all.
I will say, yeah, that's a good point.
Sorry.
It really couldn't have happened at a better time, though, if we're being honest.
For our venture here?
Yes.
And for our lifestyle? Yes.
Yeah. And except football, I think everybody would agree. Like, listen, I get it. You know, there's diehard basketball and hockey fans and stuff out there, so... Playoffs and their season's getting cut is shitty, especially March Madness. That's the worst.
It's like that for all the athletes, especially kids in college, kids in high school
those
too.
Those seniors,
like I couldn't imagine, you know, playing high school and then like your senior year, they're just like, nah, you're done.
Yeah,
like damn, because like some of the best memories came from then. You know,
I feel bad, but listen, where it's football still on schedule, these sick sons of bitches went through with free agency and everything else. So
the one thing I'm really sad about is basically springtime. In New York, it's just canceled.
Yeah.
Everywhere
is
canceled.
Yeah, well, that's the only thing that sucks is it's starting to get, like, nice outside and, like, everyone's just, like, stay inside.
I will say.
That's when Mark season kicks off.
My favorite hobby is, it shouldn't be canceled, golf.
I think golf's okay.
Golf should be fun, right?
I think golf's good because you're only with a
small group. That's huge. I'm going to be golfing so much.
Yeah, dude, I'm thinking.
So much.
It's just going to be on a case-by-case basis, I think, like businesses and places like that.
Let's hope. Let's hope for the best. Hopefully it's sooner rather than later.
Stay safe out there. Stay inside.
Wash your hands.
Wash your hands.
My hands are so like.
Wash your fucking hands.
Clean. It's crazy. Same.
I actually feel like my hands are starting to like peel because I've been washing them.
They're like
peeling. Yeah.
Washing the skin off. It's great.
Which is good. I saw, you know what's also a really funny part about it is like you sent us the Killers one, like all the artists out there that make songs.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you're like supposed to wash like 25 seconds or whatever. They keep like playing their songs while you're washing.
It's great.
To let you know how long to wash
you
your
know
hands
what
for.
I was thinking about too?
Tell us, Andy.
OnlyFans and like cam girls are going to be fucking raking it in.
Who is?
Cam girls and like OnlyFans. Like
there's
going to be.
You know what we should have done for her to go? We should have been like, most profitable businesses to be in during the fucking coronavirus.
I mean, this is going
to
be going on for a little while. So
yeah,
I think next
you're right.
Week
we're
we'll
not
going
to do a
hurry
today because we got a lot to touch on in free agency, but we have a bunch of interesting topics.
Yeah, that's why we're doing a 10-minute intro first.
I forgot we were even like on set right now.
It was good. It was good back and forth.
It was.
Yeah, I'm just talking to you guys.
All right. Let's get into some fantasy football because that's what y'all are here to listen to. This is just hectic. This is coming out Friday. So
yeah.
By the time you guys hear this, you know what, actually? We'll see if Scott can chop it up. I don't know if I'm going to get to getting out my normal video for Thursday because I have just too much
there
going on
be
between
that much
now.
Edit.
It shouldn't be, but we keep talking, so it is going to end up being a lot.
That's a good point.
So by the time you hear this, we're filming this Tuesday, 5 p.m. So fucking hold all the comments about how we were wrong about shit or how things happened.
Like
after
certain
we talk
guys,
about it.
Like if we talk about Cam Newton right now and maybe he doesn't get traded, you know.
We're going to talk about things that have already happened so that we could actually give some analysis for it going forward. Where do you guys want to start? Animal, I know you have some questions for us. Do you want to just do like general breakdowns first? I'm going to let you lead
this
one. Show what kind of leadership you've fucking
I was kind of figuring we'd just bring up a player, discuss a little bit about it, and then if I have a question for them, we'll go into that. So you want to go by positions? I think we should go by positions. We'll go by positions.
Sure.
Let's start with the running backs. Kenyan Drake staying in Arizona.
Gets a transy tag.
This was like a one that we kind of all saw coming.
We also hoped for it too. That's where we
want to. I just want to get it out of the way.
Best case scenario was him staying here. Also, with David Johnson going over to Houston means Kenyan Drake, for now, is the workhorse here. What do you think is more likely, that they don't draft someone? How do you see the backfield playing out? Do you think Kenyan Drake is, over the last half of last year, he was on pace for workhorse touches?
I think he's going to keep with that same role.
You don't think it's going to be like a 1A, 1B with him and Chase Edmonds?
I think it's going to be like a 1... Like 1A. 1-2. Yeah. Like,
you think he's going to be starting running back with a backup?
Like one
back.
Capital A, like one lowercase B, like Chase Edmonds. Like he's going to be there to take away.
Like, sure, again, Chase Edmonds came in and fucking busted off for like $135.
Yeah, you should have seen what he did against the Giants.
I'm sure, exactly. Yeah. But like, that's like when Drake's tired, they'll use him. I don't think it's going
to
be like.
So you don't think it gets to the point this summer where like people are like, oh, I like Chase Edmonds as a possible like 10 to 12 touch a game guy? Or is he just strictly just like.
Well,
I'm sure he will probably towards the end of the season, but I think like first five games, you're going to see Drake get.
No, I think he's a good complimentary back to Drake. So I'm not.
I wonder if they come out of the draft of the back.
I think that would be silly.
Same. Maybe like a fifth or sixth rounder. I can see it happening. All right. So
the other running back is, and this is where our question will tie in. David Johnson goes to Houston. And I think it doesn't change anything for me for David Johnson.
Noah sent me a poll. Someone put on Twitter asking what you'd give up for David Johnson in Dynasty. The first choice was like the 104 to the 108, and that had like 13% of the votes.
Come on.
And I wouldn't give up a third rounder for David Johnson right now.
I wouldn't give up
shit. I don't want David Johnson at all.
No, absolutely not.
There's nothing I would give up.
But dude, I've heard like multiple podcasts from people that I actually respect their opinions on. They're like, I'm going to be targeting David Johnson in the fourth round. I'm like, you're out of your fucking mind.
Yeah, that's insane.
So here's the question.
He's close to 30. He completely fallen off.
He hasn't been good in 5 years.
So Kenyan Drake, we know, didn't play that full season last year. Yeah. So does 2020 David Johnson outperform 2019 Kenyan Drake?
No.
Half PPR. And if you want, I can give you Kenyan Drake.
What finished, do you mean outperform overall?
Like fantasy points wise.
Oh, so
Kenyan Drake finished with at RB 16, 189 fantasy points.
No. So is Dave Johnson.
Dave Johnson's full season this year can be
top 15? No.
No, you won't even.
Range of outcomes, I think it's a possibility that he falls into the 13 to 15 range, only because we saw how many touches Carlos Hyde got. We know how bad Bill O'Brien is, and he'll force the fucking issue if he needs to.
Yeah, I feel like they're just going to feed him until he burns out.
Because it might be at a point where it's just like, this is the move I made. Everyone's laughing at me. I have to prove that I'm right. Mm-hmm. So we could see it. I just don't think David Johnson is talented make it out.
I knew you were going to go there.
I think the better question might be, who gets more touches next year, David Johnson or Kenyan Drake?
See, there I could see David Johnson just for that simple reason.
Touches, for sure.
So if you had to put money on it right now, who gets more?
More touches?
Yeah, touches?
David Johnson.
And we're presuming that they play a full season or like the same amount of games?
Let's go 16 apiece.
Yeah, I would say David Johnson.
Same amount of games, David Johnson, more touches.
Where do you project him to be in the touch range? Assuming that like on opening day, both of those guys are respective starters in their offenses.
I mean, it's got to be 250 plus.
I was going to say, I'd say like 260.
A minimum.
I'd say about like 260 for both of them.
Push 300, yeah.
Yeah. See, but like 300, like
that's a lot.
You kind of have to like any running back that gets 300.
Well, that's at that point. Yeah. Like, but no, I can't.
The range of outcomes for both of them.
He told me 300 touches going 2 yards into his lineman's ass.
If you told me he's getting 285 going in the year, look, he's getting 285.
That's a good fourth round pick.
Yeah. Oh, but he's just so bad.
But it's just like,
I worry about that team being able to move the ball now with no DeAndre Hopkins.
What are they doing with their
riders?
Well, they got Randall Cobb, probably.
Yeah, that's right.
That tweet cracked me up. What'd you say?
This morning?
Texans fans breathe a sigh of relief.
Yeah. Dude, I feel like, I don't feel bad for any team because I'm a Falcons fan, but like.
No, I feel bad for our guy Isaiah.
Yeah.
He's a diehard Texan fan.
Yeah, I feel bad for Texans fans. If I had anything inside me, what they call empathy, I would feel it for the Texans fans, but I don't. So Randall Cobb goes to the Texans. This is not interesting at all. We could talk about more Arizona stuff.
Yeah, Arizona's like the
big... Or do we have more running backs you want to touch on? Oh, let's talk about Jordan Howard.
Jordan Howard's the newest addition. Jordan Howard to Miami. I have Jordan Howard in our Dynasty League, so I'm actually excited about this.
This is... pretty much best case scenario if you own him in Dynasty League, because he, in his range of outcomes now, is him being the leading runner in that backfield. So, I mean, we look at Jordan Howard last year, and I mean, the beginning of the year with Philly, he was basically their starter, and he played really well. I mean, he only appeared in 9 games, but 4.5 yards a carry, six touchdowns. Yeah. Like, he was, by all intents and purposes, I mean, fantasy points, this was right on par with basically every other year that he's had.
I mean, I've never not liked Jordan Howard as a running back. So,
he's very boring.
I think he's talented.
The problem here is that, I mean, the range of outcomes for Miami is good, but they're 100% going to come away from the draft with a running back, an early running back.
Probably the first round. That's the only thing that worries me is that, like, do they take Jonathan Taylor and then, like,
there's a lot of reports that they like Dobbins a lot.
Week six.
There you go. Another one. Just throwing a name out there. But
like, week six, week four. Dobbins is a
good pass catcher. I mean, that like,
they've loaded up on defense so far on free agency, so it only makes sense.
Well, that's the thing with Jordan Howard, too. He's not catching passes.
Yeah, well, that's why they would need a counterpiece to him. And Flores.
Patrick Laird, my man.
Flores comes from New England, so, I mean, the system over there has always used multiple fucking running backs, so we could see something similar to that. I mean, that would, as much as you like Dobbins as a prospect, caps the ceiling by a pretty hefty amount. Good talk, guys.
He was talking to you.
I just said it. What do you mean I'm talking to him? It was just a fucking as much as we like Dobbins as a prospect, it caps his ceiling.
Oh, where? Miami?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good talk, guys.
The Giants signed some linebackers. Right,
lead us through the next fucking the rest of the episode.
All right, well, so I think we should go back to Arizona here because that's like the biggest splash. Well, this is
the big one. The one that made you drop your jaw to the ground.
Yeah, Deandre Hopkins is going to Arizona for nothing. And
literally,
Kyler Murray has now. How far has Kyler Murray gone up?
David Johnson's salary off the books.
That's the crazy thing. When I first read about it, I didn't realize that they're taking the whole salary. I thought maybe it would cut in half or something.
They're basically saving like $11 million.
I figured while adding DeAndre Hopkins, possibly the best receiver in football.
Well, no, yeah, but I'm saying the Texans, like their reasoning for this is to like save money in the cap. You just paid Randall Cobb too. It's like the whole, I don't really want to even go into the whole really how bad the trade is. Fantasy football. How good is this for Kyler Murray?
So good.
Like, how far does he go up on your QB rankings? Because, you know, right now you're looking at Mahomes.
We'll put it this way. Anyone who puts him outside the top five is just trying to get a reaction out of other people.
Yeah.
You have to.
I would say Mahomes, Lamar Jackson, and then he's in the debate right there at three.
Russell, him.
Yeah, I'll go Russ.
He's definitely over Deshaun Kyler.
Yeah. I mean, Russ was not that good last year at all.
No, he wasn't. He definitely
Would I straight up, who would I take this upcoming year? I actually think I might take Kyler over Russ. If I came to the actual draft day, I probably would feel safer taking Russ. Yeah. I'd probably
That's where you have to.
But like, you can't argue against it.
No, if someone like took Kyler over Russ, I wouldn't be like, oh, how could you do that? Like,
I would be like, I respect that.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know if I'd do it, but I respect
it. No, I think it might be too ballsy for me. I think I would you know pick the commodity in Russ.
That's the unfortunate part because you're going to have to take him out.
Right, of course. And this is coming from me, a guy who was not really a fan of Kyler, but
you guys need to change your ways because it was Lamar Jackson, it was Kyler, and I was just like, listen, boys.
Hey.
Neither of you guys like
We have admitted it, or at least I know I have.
Yeah, well, we said it about Lamar.
Dead wrong. But watching Kyler last year and in that offense with Cliff Kingsbury, sky's the limit.
Ceiling's
the roof for that offense next year.
But D-Hop.
D-Hop especially.
Does D-Hop have more fantasy points this year than he did last year?
Yes. Has to.
I don't know.
I don't either.
I think so.
I still caught 104 balls last year.
Yeah.
But assimilating into the offense.
In what felt like a quiet year.
And the reason he even did that was because Will Fuller missed a lot of
years. What were the touchdowns?
Seven, I think.
Yeah.
I thought it was like 11, 50, and seven.
Yeah. I think he goes double-digit touchdowns this year.
I could see it. I mean, he's competing with better targets.
Yeah.
In Christian Kirk and
more reliable targets, yeah.
Yeah, he's competing with different targets.
McGuire Fitz is still there. He's still gonna see.
I just think like the first year in a new offense is always not bad, but I don't think the ceiling is really there. So I'm like looking at this as, you know, maybe next year is when he can get back to that 1600, 1700, you know, really take back over the wide receiver position. So I don't know if I'm going to be on board with
We've seen him do
the adjustment year, get the report.
Which is fine. He's still going to put up numbers, but he's definitely falling down a little bit at first glance. We've seen him put up numbers with garbage, literally like Charlie Yates or whatever those fucking quarterbacks' names were, and he was putting up wide receiver.
So where does D-Hop start going in drafts? Who do you start taking above him? And blow him and shit like that.
I mean, it's running backs and Michael Thomas and then D-Hop.
Like if someone...
Yeah. Well, last
he's
year
my wide
last
receiver
year
two.
He's your two.
Yeah.
Oh, hell no. He's not my
two. Who's your wide receiver two?
Tyreek Hill.
Yeah. I would go Thomas, Hill, Adams.
I would go Adams too, still.
I would go...
Yeah, D-Hop drops for over me after Adams. This move. D-Hop drops.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Remember last year was you were between D-Adams and Hopkins, and I was going to take whoever you didn't.
Right.
Adams is way over Hopkins now.
You guys are both Adams over Hopkins right now.
Yes.
Really? See, I think it's not even close.
It depends what happens in the draft because I do think the Packers end up going with the wide receiver early.
Which I think it's still is fine.
I would also slide Amari Cooper into my top five.
Why?
because I think he's going to have a monster year with McCarthy
I'm
with there.
I'm a really big fan of Cooper this year.
I think with the way that McCarthy runs his offenses. Nah, look at the years that Davante Adams had when McCarthy was there. Okay, but wait,
didn't you guys just say the same thing? Did
no, we were Hopkins talking about
his first in a new offense.
Yeah, but I mean, it's just because there's
Cooper's
so many other
in a new offense.
There's other weapons there, and you got a rookie quarterback.
I guess.
Well, Hopkins still is there. The new piece. Yeah. Where Cooper's okay, been with Dak and fair. Cooper's
that's
been.
That's fine. They still have the chemistry and all. Running a different playbook. That's right, but it's still. I don't know if I put him top five, and he wasn't that great last year. If you put him on the road, he did nothing.
He was
nothing.
Also dealing with an injury all last year, and he played through it.
Okay. And
but he kind of always is, I feel like.
Always. Yeah, and Davante Adams
I'm with you, though. I like Cooper a lot. I think Cooper's a
monster. I'm not saying I dislike Cooper. I'm just saying he got shoot him up. And
he only got fewer than 120. He got 119 targets last year. If he goes up to that 140, 145 yeah, mark, he's going to be a problem.
Yeah.
Well, of course, but you got to go. It's a big
year coming for Cooper.
I don't think it's really that big
contract.
Why not?
Because, I mean, he was in and out of games last year and shit, and this is going to be a more...
And that team as a whole last year was all over the place.
They ran the ball in like 58% of their plays, yeah, which was not a high pay. It was bigger than...
No, I don't... Listen.
It was a bigger gap than a typical year for them.
I'm not being biased at all either. I'm just saying, I think...
If that
I don't think
goes
he's
from,
top five if that right now.
No, I would put him borderline there, though.
Amari Cooper or Chris Godwin? Now, we don't know who the quarterback is in Tampa, but...
Let's assume it's Brady.
Well, I like Godwin a lot more than... And what Evans
I mean, I did last year, but I don't know about this year.
I will go with Cooper there.
I probably would too because James. They,
me too.
James just
you lose, sir.
What about? What about another guy?
Go.
How about Cooper or Galladay? I mean, it's Cooper.
Cooper.
Yeah. I'm going by like ADP here.
Cooper
or Juju.
Cooper.
It's not. That's not even close.
Cooper or Sutton. I mean, ADP wise, they're all in the same.
Yeah,
round.
Maybe he goes top five.
Cooper.
Like Cooper's way too low.
That's what I almost think Cooper's going to be in there just because.
But by like
they have Allen Robinson,
Julio or Hopkins.
That's absurd.
I would take Julio.
I would take Hopkins right now.
I mean, yeah, he's your wide receiver too, so you can't answer.
There's only one guy you take over him, so it's like I would probably take Julio. I go Thomas, Hill, Adams, Julio, Hopkins would probably be my five.
I think that's probably me too.
And okay. then you could argue Cooper right there, yeah. And then with the Godwin, the Evans,
but you're not allowed to argue
right
before then. All right, let's go.
All right, who's next? We got, sticking with wide receivers, Stefon Diggs.
Ah, this one.
I haven't talked about this one yet, yeah.
Going to Buffalo.
I'm very interested in this one because Josh Allen has a cannon. He's just going to throw the ball up.
So, yeah, like we were talking about this before in the car.
How long until Diggs starts getting fucking angry there?
Well, that's the thing. I think it's going to be a very similar Stefon Diggs, like numbers and stats wise. Like he's going to have those sporadic.
He keeps flirting around like the 1050 to 1150 yards mark. But. The same argument you make for Cooper, if Diggs... Oh, okay, so look at it this way. Like, Diggs was in Minnesota, right? Like,
right.
Arguably, I mean, he was sharing the ball with Adam Thielen. Like, Adam Thielen and Dalvin Cook are both incredible playmakers in the NFL.
Yes, very
He
good.
Goes to Buffalo and immediately becomes the alpha athlete in that offense. Like, there's no one that should be game plan to get the ball over him, right? So he goes there. There's no reason why he shouldn't command 140 targets. It's not unreasonable.
You would think at minimum.
Last year, he went off for... Over 1,100 yards. Guess how many targets Stefon Diggs got last year? Like 1,130 yards.
85. 90. 94.
What's your final guess?
94.
109. 93.
Oh, wow.
He only got 93 targets last year.
I knew it was under 100.
1,100 yards.
Him and A.J. Brown were the only two.
He had like 60-yard receptions.
Yeah, it should have
been. Him and A.J. Brown were the only two wide receivers in the top 25 of fantasy to have under 115 targets. He had 93.
He could fucking
if he
ball.
Goes from 93 to 145 next year, even if some of them are inaccurate,
say, you're gonna, you got to figure
can
at least
you start
40
putting
of those.
Him in the top five?
40 of those are going to be...
targets?
This is a situation
10 yards
where
over his head.
You're right. Well, it is. But the fact that he's becoming the alpha, I mean, I just feel like they're going to game plan that offense around him. They've been looking for a one for Josh Allen, and I could see the volume really going up. So people will immediately be like, it's Buffalo, it's Josh Allen, inaccurate. I think if you dig a little deeper, like the volume game is one you could play here.
Listen, John Brown was also really good with Josh Allen.
John Brown was great last year,
And I think I might like John Brown more than I like him now.
Yep. Right now, Diggs' ADP is around the fifth round, anywhere from the 5-1 to the 5-6. I think it's going to go
him in the fifth round.
Low. Yeah, I think you'll probably see it go maybe in the fourth now. I think people will like him more. Here's the question, though. Diggs, Cup, Devontae Parker. They're all the same ADP.
Diggs.
This is a redraft.
Cooper Cup, Devontae Parker.
Yep. I mean, like, recency bias for me, I want Parker. Just because of what I don't think he's going to replicate what he did. So
that's
like,
a great question. Parker's probably the last one of the three that I want.
I think I would take Diggs and then Diggs, Cup,
That's my Those two are really hard to cover.
Is coming off that second year removed, even though he was already
that's what I'm thinking about in the first year.
Him and Goff just have an uncanny connection, man.
I just think about, like you said, maybe recency bias alone because
Brandon Cooks get moved.
If that's the case, I'd probably switch. You know, obviously, even though Cooks was pretty much a non-factor last year anyway.
I like Cup,
but Cup's second half of the year was a massive.
It was down.
Dud.
Yeah. It was a mess.
But that whole team
we'll never
was...
know what the fuck the reason was.
No, of course not. Of course not.
So I think it was just the team was just struggling.
I probably trust Diggs, and especially if he's going to get anywhere near that target share, like 140.
You know what I'm saying? Like when you start to actually think about it, you're like, ooh, maybe he can be really interesting.
Right, and he's uber talented. More so, I love Cup, but he's obviously more talented than Cooper. So
yeah.
So
yes.
I'd go
Diggs, Cup, Parker.
I'm going to go Cup, Diggs, Parker.
Yeah, I'd probably go Cup, Diggs, Parker. Like recent
Parker is the one.
I said because of the recency bias. Like at first, I think I want Parker just because, but I don't think he's going to replicate what he did.
Okay. Why don't we talk about the biggest move in free agency so far? Jimmy Graham going to the Bears.
No, I was going to say, that's not even on my list.
Jimmy Graham gets $8 million a year to go to the Chicago
fucking
Bears.
He's got nudes.
He has to have nudes of everybody's wives because... The Chicago Bears got to see Jimmy Graham play in Green Bay four times over the last fucking 2 years.
Did he reach over 30 yards?
His stat line, he had two games. He had 30 yards in one game, 32 yards in another. The other game, he had zero. The other game, he had 8 yards.
Big fat zero.
What the fuck were they watching?
Jimmy Graham is still getting paid off of the fact that his name is Jimmy Graham. That's it. Like, people are like, oh, Jimmy Graham, he's a good football player.
It was New Orleans, he was dominant, and then he was in
Seattle.
Yeah,
that was it. Yeah. New Orleans was the last time he was good.
Well, he had a double-digit touchdown season in Seattle, but it was like 30 catches, yeah. 400 yards,
it was like, what's
52 touchdowns.
Yeah. Yeah, it was terrible.
It was like Daniel Fells this year with Houston. It was like he had like 20 catches.
He got re-signed.
14
he got an
of
extension.
Them were touchdowns, yeah.
Yeah.
He's going to be the new Deandre Hopkins.
Jimmy Graham, let's not talk about
it. All right, so we got that tight end out of the way. let's go to some actual tight ends.
Okay, yes, Jason Witten to the Raiders.
The Giants signed one, too. I don't even know how to pronounce his name. Vet minimum from San Fran. I have no idea.
Dwelly? Russ Dwelly?
Doesn't matter.
No, with a Z.
All right, so let's go with the big signing. Austin Hooper to Cleveland.
Crazy. This one came out of nowhere.
This is funny because he has Hooper
and
Njoku on Go Fade Me.
And Njoku in my dynasty. So
worst case scenario just happened right there.
Really.
You couldn't name a worst case.
And that was the first move that we really woke up to when it's when it started. That was the first one in motion.
Dude, the last 24 hours was nuts.
So
in the NFL.
I know. The thing with this one is Austin Hooper to me is just one more player I'm not interested in on the Browns in an already crowded offense.
See, I wouldn't say not interested. I like Hunt and Chubb.
Outside of Chubb, who's the running back? They bring in
Jack Conklin at tackle.
Remember last week when I said, can we talk about linemen? I'd really like to see the Browns beef up that line.
Yes.
Because they're going to be a heavy running
great
team.
Great for Chubb and Hunt. But I have no interest in Austin Hooper. I think he takes
a big hit.
He takes a huge hit. He goes from Cutter.
His best option was to stay in Atlanta.
But reasonably, though, he could still be a 50 for 600 and get 8 to 10 touchdowns.
I was just going to say, I completely
agree with the touchdowns because Baker loves throwing to the tight ends in the red zone.
That's the thing. So Hooper's still in the tight end one mix, but he's going to be nowhere near the reception totals they had last year and the target totals were nuts in Atlanta.
What he did last year, what was he?
He was like tight end two.
Two? Three? He's
In points per game, when he was in the game, he was like an elite tight end.
Yeah, so I see him what? Tight end's still scarcity, so I'm
still
five, maybe. Like
I'd probably go in the 7 to 10 range.
Yeah, because there's like
he'll probably get drafted in the 7, but his value will be like 9 to 10.
We already know you're gonna take Kittle and you're gonna take
Kelsey.
Kittle,
and
Kelsey,
Ertz, and Andrews over him.
Yeah.
Now here comes the next guy.
Give us the next guy.
Do you do Waller?
Yes, easily.
Yeah, I would.
Hooper?
Over Hooper, yeah.
Evan Ingram?
Yes.
Ingram's scary.
I think I'd rather take
Ingram's
Hooper.
A guy I would draft the backup tight end. Because you have Ian Thomas, you have Jonnu Smith, who are both their respective own guys now. I'm not taking them over Hooper, but if I'm drafting a guy like Ingram, I want security backup.
I think you had wrote on Twitter, I'm sorry, I know you're about to speak, you had said Hooper in the 5th or...
Gesicki in the 8th. That's
right.
What I was going to get.
Oh, you wrote that. I'm sorry. Yeah.
Oh,
that's
I was
what
like,
I'm
what are you
sorry.
Talking about?
Yeah.
I would rather take Gesicki in the 8th. I would rather take a tight end later that I think is going to have just as much
of an
opportunity.
You like Gesicki this year? This is off topic.
Why? I think just from the end of the year, you saw he was starting to make plays.
But don't you think that was a little bit of the Parker effect where literally every playmaker on their team was hurt?
Yeah, but he's young and talented. He's an athlete. I mean,
yeah.
I think you just got to get
Gesicki too.
I do too.
Even all right, so even
I
not
think
Gesicki.
People are going to lean on him as like a realistic starting tight end option.
Which is
I don't
mistake,
think it's going
right.
to be
that's
the
a
case.
Mistake.
Because there was a report that came out that he's going to be like the big slot receiver. I looked it up last year. He ran like 73% of his snaps from the slot. He already was the big slot receiver last year. So he's not getting much more.
Yeah, but there
was
a
number
quarterback
one
carousel going on. There was a whole mess there.
Agreed, which is why that's why he got the volume, which is like. Yeah.
But in this terms, I think I would take him three rounds later.
If Hooper's in the fifth round, there's no way I'm taking him there.
No, that's the real.
So then here we go. Hooper in the fifth or Jonnu Smith in the ninth? Possibly 10th. Like, I'm all over Jonnu Smith.
Yeah,
absolutely.
That I would take.
Value-wise,
this is why like tight ends are tricky. Like, there's just, like, these guys.
It's very tricky. I feel pretty
problem
bummed
there
out because I liked Hooper.
Yeah, Hooper just doesn't belong really in the fifth hit. Round. That's the problem with all these questions. How can Hooper be a fifth-round pick when, like, Ertz is going to be in the fourth, probably?
So, put Hooper in the sixth. Hooper in the sixth or Jack Doyle in the tenth? With Phillip Rivers there now.
I kind of like Doyle now. I kind of like Doyle getting the extension. Ebron gone. Ebron hasn't signed it right now.
Like, I'd rather take Jack Doyle in the tenth.
I feel like. Oh, they got Sternberger.
Early 11th than take Hooper in the sixth.
I hear you. I just think the point here is just that Hooper, his value gets hurt a lot.
That's
what you can get.
We'll
from
see
all
if
that.
They run a lot of two tread tight end lightly. Sets because Stefanski, I guess, did that a little bit with Rudolph and Irv Smith, but it wasn't really
it's
that
very
high
puzzling. I wonder what his market was and who he heard from, like which teams and Hooper? Whatnot. Yeah, because I mean, it was so quick. He's obviously probably been hearing, you know, through back channels with other teams. I'm like genuinely curious because for himself,
do you think that puts Njoku on the trade block?
No, well, they say he's safe. They say they want to use
two
tight ends.
Well, yes, Stefanski likes two tight ends, apparently, so.
Yeah, but like,
they could probably get decent
numbers
value for
say
him.
That
and
year.
he's like, why would you want two young tight ends? Like, trade.
That's what I mean. They could probably get something nice for Njoku.
Yeah,
right
I think
now,
you can get a
I've been
second or
the Giants.
What we gave up for Hayden Hurst, we probably could have got fucking David Njoku instead.
Yeah.
And would you rather?
I would actually rather Hurst, to be honest.
Yeah.
So let's go on to Hurst, actually, because that's the next tight end here. He goes to Atlanta. They give up a pretty decent amount, which I think they may have overpaid, but
hefty.
That's irrelevant to fantasy.
This is what I'm going to put on the record, and I said this yesterday, not into this amount of depth, though. I think Hayden Hurst is going to be very good for us this year, and I think everyone is going to make a statement right now within the next couple weeks saying this was a horrible deal for Atlanta. We're going to look back. Hayden Hurst is going to play really well, and if your team gets a tight end that plays really well for you, are you okay having sacrificed a second-round pick?
Most yeah, because you'd probably have to draft someone. You have to give up a second round pick.
So I think we're going to look back at the end of the year and being like, that Atlanta move wasn't that bad.
I don't think so. And I think Hayden Hurst, he was buried in Baltimore. And when he showed his glimpses, he was beast.
Fine.
Yeah,
he
so
was beast.
This is what
same exact
he had,
profile as Austin Hooper.
And look
has.
How and look
40
how
targets
he got
last year, 30 receptions. My question is, Hayden Hurst, 60 and a half receptions over under.
Well, you said he had 40 last year?
He had 40 targets, 30 receptions.
How many catches did Austin Hooper have last
Austin
year?
Austin Hooper had 97 targets and 75 receptions.
In how many games? 13?
In 13.
Could see him going over 60.
I would say he's going to
like.
That's really close because you don't want to throw that. That's like a tough number for a
tight end. I think 65
for sure,
is attainable.
I don't think the offensive philosophy is going to change. If he picks that up, he's going to be fine.
Exactly.
The defense is still
going to
be shit.
They don't
games.
Have a running back, right? They could easily. He could easily be in the market.
It's just hard to, you know, count on someone who's never really caught a lot.
Yeah,
of
you don't know
not.
If he can handle like, you know, 8 targets a game or whatever.
I think he should be able to get 70, 75 targets.
Number 8 targets a game. That's like 150 targets. I know. It's like Julio.
The math is not my fucking
70 to 75 targets is. I feel like that's not unrealistic. That's 20 less than.
But
Hooper.
He's not catching 60 of 70 though.
He just caught
30 of 40.
That would be 60 of 80. Not 70. But either way, it's just like all throw
so
balls.
So you're under 60 and a half. You fucking over or under?
I'll say over.
Shit.
I like when you're...
I say good. Over.
I think it's a good number.
I'm going to say 59.
Yeah, I picked it myself. 59.
It's a good number.
I picked it myself.
59.
59? 100. Damn, you really just going to do me like that? All right.
What
you know what we're
going to
have
personally?
I set the line. It's
a good line.
In the HQ, we're going to have a bet board.
Like that.
Sure.
We have to figure out a way to get your big thing to New York.
We should... See if we could fit it in there after this. Just like see how it fits.
Fit in the truck?
Yeah.
I still have the wood in there though.
Yeah, that's right. We'll angle it the other way.
I can't bring that in.
It's not
going to
fit in that
go
car.
There.
It would never fit. Yeah, you're right.
Well, there's no way.
We'll get Steve's truck. We'll do it.
All right. Steve's coming on Sunday. His brother-in-law's coming too. He can come take. I think he can mount the TV.
He can come take it wherever the fuck he wants.
Well, he's already taken my bed and my desk.
Sorry, he can fit it.
Go, keep going.
Who do we have left here? Oh, we can move on to. I think that's it for the skill positions. Outside of like the.
So what the fuck else we gotta talk about?
The quarterbacks. We did not touch on any of the quarterbacks yet.
I mean, Mariota's.
I am actually very intrigued with the Marcus Mariota to the Raiders.
You usually tell us why after.
No, I just I think it's intriguing because I'm waiting to see what happens with Carr. I wouldn't be shocked if we see Derek Carr get traded.
What happened?
Did he just get traded? No, he got traded right now.
No, I swear to God, he didn't. We might have to cut this out. I feel really bad for laughing. Kevin Durant has the coronavirus.
I saw definitely don't cut that out.
I'm really sorry. It's karma.
I mean,
it's karma for not coming to the Knicks.
Yeah.
Literally a good chance that we all have it right now.
100% chance. I'm really sorry. That's fucked up to laugh.
It's not that funny. You see, as long as he doesn't die, it's not fucked up.
Exactly. Listen, I
Scott, if he dies by Friday, edit this out.
Like, there's no. I would put so much money that I'm getting the corona within the next week.
I think so.
Have it already.
I probably do. Yeah. Although I felt really good the last few days.
I feel fine.
Yesterday, I did the push-ups and I did all that stuff too.
Good shit.
It felt great because I've been working from home for like 2 weeks now. I'm losing my mind.
Yeah.
So Marcus Mariota,
is
a Las Vegas Raider. What are the chances that he Tannehill's Carr?
At some point, yes. It's yes. He's like, going to start games
this season, week five. Is Mariota the starter?
Do we have the schedule yet?
I think we do. What are we looking for, the Raiders schedule?
I want to know the Raiders schedule because a lot of that depends on how they start the season. You know what I mean? Like if he goes 3-1, there's no way they're sitting in week five. But if he goes 1-3, then they could start looking.
Week one, Atlanta. I don't know if that's preseason though. I don't think so.
Oh, I don't think we even know if preseason's happening.
Week one, it just says date TBA.
Okay. So we're probably not on the schedule. Either way, I think it's almost definite that Mariota, it's like Gruden went out and got Mariota. Like he likes the kid, obviously.
And Mayock is a huge Mariota guy.
Go back and watch Mariota and Gruden's Gruden QB camp.
He loved him.
Yeah. So
I mean, he loves everybody.
It's a good point.
Ridiculous. Yeah, I think Mariota will start games this year. I think Derek Carr is like not good enough to have a 16-game season where he's just on point with everything.
They seem to be committed to him. I mean, you know, Mariota's not coming in taking the job right away. I don't think.
What was Mariota's contract?
3 years. I can look it up.
What?
I look it up.
3 years.
What?
Yeah, it doesn't say the actual terms of the deal.
I can't find. Yeah, they just keep saying like. Ryan Tannehill signed a 4-year, $118
million
deal.
Yeah, I was
going to
say, I don't think the numbers came out for Mariota.
Give a shit.
No, it didn't. It doesn't say.
I don't think so. A lot of numbers aren't.
I love it. He's just making these 3-year, 4-year max contract. What? Okay, so yeah, no.
So this is probably like a 3-year, 60 mil.
Okay.
Yeah, 58 mil.
Okay, are you fucking done?
Yeah, but so Superflex leagues. Any interest in Marcus Mariota at all?
I'll draft him just because you draft every quarterback, but like he's in like that 30 range.
He's not even going to be.
Do you believe at all that he can like revive his career?
I don't.
I personally think he has a chance. How? I don't hate Mariota.
We've seen wilder things.
I just think he was in a situation where like they didn't let him loose, or maybe he didn't feel like he could let himself loose. He seemed too timid all the time.
But wait, why? They were running the same shit with Henry.
I don't. Maybe something happened.
Tannehill came in. They win 6 of 7. They go to the AFC Championship game. Tannehill got casted off from Miami. Why couldn't Mariota do it? Same system, same everything.
I could see Mariota being a good fantasy quarterback.
He just looked really bad
again at some point this year.
He looked really bad.
He did. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He looked like he was scared to throw the ball. He couldn't make any throws. And you saw when Tannehill came in.
Granted,
they didn't throw the ball a lot, but when they did, they make a big play downfield. He wasn't afraid to let it go.
Tannehill.
Yeah.
Right.
Mariota was. So,
but they gave Mariota the chances, and he just wouldn't do it.
Sometimes
you
just need a new team, new scenery, all that stuff.
Over-under game started for Mariota, 5.5.
Under.
Fuck, I'm going to go over. I think Gruden loves him.
I don't think he loves him that much. I'm sorry.
You can't
sit there and tell me, like, talent-wise, Mariota's better than Carr.
I think Gruden hates Derek Carr.
I think Carr gives him a better chance to win.
I actually think he likes Derek Carr.
I do, too, because Gruden's been ruthless. They traded fucking Khalil Mack like that.
Yeah.
Like, if they didn't want Carr, they would have gotten rid of him already.
I think he understands the importance of having a quarterback, so he's not going to just, like, send off his
I think the Raiders are quietly building a really good team. They just signed two linebackers. I wanted for the Giants, Littleton and
Littleton's
the
guy a good signing
from Chicago. I think they know what they're doing. So maybe if this pushes Carr a little bit, and this is Carr's end game, they draft the quarterback next year.
We talked about Mariota.
I don't understand. He's dirt. Shout out, Yannick.
Just, you know,
he's lower than dirt.
Just mentioning it. All right, next quarterback.
Sorry,
Mr. Teddy Bridgewater going to the Carolina Panthers.
This is interesting.
Yeah.
This is interesting for his playmakers.
I really like this for DJ Moore.
Yep.
I mean, I like it for Samuel just because you have an accurate quarterback there. I just don't like it because of Samuel's game.
There's nothing I like about Curtis Samuel, to be honest.
Why do you hate on Curtis Samuel so much? I think he's very talented. Run after the catch guy. It doesn't get enough credit for
it. The only thing you see about Curtis Samuel, about why he's going to be good, is the fact that his quarterback was bad. We don't actually hear about how he's been good when he gets accurate throws. Well, everyone's just like, well, his quarterback missed on 80% of his throws. That doesn't mean he was good. Well, that just means a quarterback overthrew him.
Which is why I'm not like excited that it's Teddy Bridgewater. I'm more excited the fact that Teddy Bridgewater is an accurate thrower, whereas like Curtis Samuel's biggest problem last year was he was just getting tons of air yards and no balls actually.
Okay, Teddy Bridgewater Superflex League's interest level. Mm.
Still very minimal.
I never loved it at Teddy Bridgewater.
Yeah.
He started 34 games,
guy.
Right?
And he's an 18 fucking point ceiling guy.
He's gone over two touchdowns or more in 4 games out of 34 starts.
Twice.
More than
2 total touchdowns in a game just
twice. Oh, I had that stat. Yeah. Nice.
I was just looking at it right there. Yeah, he's not a stat guy.
No, he's not.
But
does it change anything McCaffrey, for C-Mac?
For C-Mac, no.
Yeah, I don't think
nothing
so.
Changes. If anything, he's just going to keep... there's nothing that changes.
Nothing really changes. I like this for DJ Moore, though, because now at least passes will be more accurate. Yep. I mean, yeah, that's really it for me. Good with DJ Moore still, good with C-Mac still. Teddy Bridgewater, 18 to 22 range for Superflex quarterbacks.
Yeah.
We could probably...
Not outside of that.
Yeah.
I was actually going to ask you like an ADP, like who were this guy or that guy, DJ Moore or Odell Beckham? Because they're very close in ADP right now.
I'd probably go Odell.
I think I would go DJ.
Me too.
I'd probably go DJ. And you know it pains me to say but I would.
DJ's on the up. Odell.
I just feel like Odell's like kind of been on a downward spiral.
They're
going to
squeak.
Years.
They're going to squeak one great year out of him. And
do you think so?
I do. He's always hurt.
I think the great year he's going to have is like 1,400 yards and 8 touchdowns though. And I think Moore is capable of doing that. I don't think Odell is.
They're like, probably right on same par if they both hit.
I just don't see Odell ever topping his best seasons again.
Oh, I pray to God. I pray he just keeps getting worse and worse.
I think that's what's going to happen.
Actually, going back to Cleveland, because you mentioned it before, you're like, Austin Hooper fits himself into a place where it's just like another weapon that I don't really want to draft.
Yeah.
They have a lot of good weapons there.
That I don't want a piece of any of them, though.
Right, but when that's the case, you usually look to the quarterback. Yeah. How intrigued are I like Baker for a little bit of a bounce back this year for fantasy.
I think going to be able to get him in a good spot.
I think they're also improving the offensive line. The offensive line is massive. Their offensive line was so bad last year.
So do you think by the time we draft, like fantasy will have hyped him up into the top 12 quarterbacks?
Baker? Maybe. I could see top 12. I could see the hype train getting up there a little bit, but I don't know. I feel like last year was really bad.
Last year was nuts. He was like quarterback 5 off the fucking board for a lot of people.
Yeah.
That's insane. His ADP, I can't even find.
I feel like a lot of people were burned, and it's going to be hard to go back to that bridge until you see something.
I can't even find Baker Mayfield right now. Oh, okay, I found him. All right, Daniel Jones or Baker Mayfield? Redraft.
I'm going to go Baker.
I'm not going to answer this.
You're going to go Daniel Jones?
Why wouldn't I?
I mean, his ADP is ranked above him. He's actually Baker's going according
to
this.
That will be the case for about another week. And then that will change.
Yeah,
Jones played 4 less
updated.
Games and had better numbers.
Yeah, I'm talking just strictly fantasy. I think Daniel Jones might be the...
I would take Daniel Jones, yeah.
I would take Baker.
Daniel Jones is more athletic. He's going to get more on the ground.
Baker Mayfield or Aaron Rodgers? Really? You still have faith in him?
It's not faith. It's just I wouldn't put...
Yeah, that's more of
Baker's,
like a less...
Baker's big bounce back over like, or an Aaron Rodgers.
I just think Aaron Rodgers is going to keep getting worse every year.
He wasn't bad, but take one good wide receiver in this draft or like put Robbie Anderson on this team. I'm back. Mm-hmm. I'm good for Rodgers.
That's
like
true.
Top 8.
Second year in LaFleur system, I think they're gonna go.
Yeah.
I'm with you on that kind of sneak.
But if they go back in with the same fucking receiving core, then no, I'm not gonna be
and it sucks. We all overestimated
receivers were abysmal. Yeah, we all thought Geronimo Allison and Marquez Valdez Scantling could get it done and they could not.
It was bad.
Fuck Geronimo.
And
I remember
picking up Lazard like for big fab money.
I actually think Lazard
is a sneaky sleeper.
I think he'll be
I'm not saying he was bad. I'm just saying it's just the overall dynamic of Green Bay wide receivers.
It's not so much like throw in the wide receiver 2 for Rodgers anymore.
Right, right. Yeah. So
I hear you. Lead the path.
This was something we actually missed. I wanted to go back when we were talking about DeAndre Hopkins and the Texans.
Oh, you wanted to talk about
the wide receiver 1.
Jimmy Graham again.
The wide receiver 1 in Houston.
All right.
Will Fuller.
You mean David Johnson?
Yeah, well, technically. No. But
wait, is Carlos Hyde coming back?
Will Fuller. Does...
Which wide receiver on this roster ends up with the fucking most fantasy points? Sorry, go.
Oh, that's Kenny actually Stills. Not a bad question.
You think it's still?
That's probably better.
I cannot trust Will Fuller.
All of them are going to end up with 72.
I was just going to go with this. Will Fuller finished as like a top 16, 17, 18.
I don't think so. No way. You cannot trust that guy to stay on the field.
He's so talented when he's on the field, though. He drops a lot of balls, don't get me wrong.
He had one fucking monster game. That was all he was good for.
He has a lot of monster games, man. Not recently. When he first came in the league.
He started off, but then he there was no way he was.
What did he do last year outside of that 40, 50 point game?
No, I know. He's a speed guy. He's a burner.
So you can't say he's had big games in the past and look 3 years back and have four injuries in between.
He's not the type of guy who, like, the wide receiver one leaves and he becomes the alpha. Like,
right, exactly.
He's
not
a piece to the offense. He's not the offense. You know what I mean?
No, I know. Well, like I say, he's the guy who needs to stretch the field.
I would say, like, top 18 or top 20 are probably more realistic.
Well, it depends on how many games he plays.
I mean, that's the biggest issue. You can't predict that.
But like if they don't get a solidified wide receiver one ahead of Fuller, what is your interest level in redraft?
Not much. I'm not going crazy.
Say they take like a third round wide receiver or something. So Fuller goes into the year as the supposed alpha.
No, I think I could get better value in like a Kenny Stills.
Yeah,
I'd
rather
Will Fuller.
Not pay up for him and take someone else.
I'm out too.
He's not like
we are out.
We've hammered home all the time about like being cautious on guys with injury history. He's walking proof of injury history.
This is also going to be a funky ass year for, depending on what happens this summer, because we don't know how long this corona shit's going to last and how you know, deep into like training camp or whatever. A lot of these guys might come back in the summer out of shape.
Out of shape.
And if they're only at practice for, you know, a month before the season starts, there's going to be a ton of fucking early season injuries. There's going to be a ton of them.
Yeah, I know,
It's going to be a weird year if something happens this way.
Are they getting the proper training they're being able to do? Yeah. No, probably not.
I want to do just a couple
Which is even worse for guys with issues like that.
Before we break down the CBA, just a couple, like maybe like wide receiver two guys, you know, this or that.
Do it to us, animal.
Christian Kirk or Michael Gallup? Who the fuck do you want?
I'm going to say Gallup. Gallup.
That one, that's a good one. I probably
Kirk's ceiling is just so fucking lowered with Deandre Hopkins there. Yeah. I still think he's a great wide receiver, too.
That's probably
You don't think it's going to open it up more for him?
No.
Yeah, I'd go Gallup.
I feel like Larry didn't really take much away.
Kirk's breakout this year would be like 1,000
yards. Is Larry Fitzgerald still there?
Yeah.
That's actually pretty crazy. I didn't think about that.
And he's actually still pretty productive.
So the last 4 years, we've been being like, this is Fitz's last year.
He's so good. He's a national treasure.
Here's the way I look at it. Christian Kirk, if he goes out there and goes for over 1,000 yards, we're like, he broke out. Michael Gallup just already went for 1,000 yards. Yeah. You know what I mean? So like, if Gallup takes even a little bit of a step forward in this offense, that should be more
patient. I like Gallup. I think... you're going to see like the old Randall Cobb numbers when Randall Cobb was in Green Bay.
Six overall.
No.
You had to look like
not
a legit top five.
That, like one year where him and Jordy were like the fucking best wide receivers in fantasy. But like those, you know, he just had those steady good years.
Yeah, I mean, fucking Mike McCarthy, all he does is produce fantasy wide receivers.
Let's go with.
I'll go Gallup.
He sucks. McCarthy.
DJ Chark.
I like this already. Go.
Or Tyler Boyd. We don't know. I mean, we know the quarterback in Cincinnati. It's going to be Burrow.
Do we know the quarterback in Jacksonville?
It's going to be Minshew.
I
think so, right?
Who he loves Chark.
He loves Chark.
I'm going to go with Chark.
You have to go Chark.
I think,
in my opinion.
You know what I like here? Low key, Gruden going over as the OC there.
Yeah, that's one of the sneaky fucking good moves. I want him to be Giants offense coordinator.
AJ Green's first 3 years in the league were the 3 years
with
that he
Jay
was
Gruden,
OC.
Right.
Jay Gruden, I think as an OC is going to be a great move.
Same. And I think DJ Chark is going
to be one of those guys that goes back to what he can do best and just does
Max,
that.
I was fucking telling you I want a Gruden.
No, I know. I like Gruden too. I think Washington kind of screwed him over. Washington never really
did. No, he's a great offensive mind.
He had a great
be one of the miserable head coaches, even though he wasn't that miserable. Alex Smith fucked him over.
He got a bad shaft.
He got a bad shaft. He did. He's a fucking good mind.
Yeah, give me Chark, but I still do like Boyd. I've always been a fan of Boyd, and I will continue to be a fan of Boyd.
No, Boyd's good, but I would take Chark, too.
I'll go Chark.
All right, you guys want to do it one more with some running backs?
You can give me
10. Yeah, I kind of like these.
All right. I will give you here, let's see, running backs. I was looking at David Montgomery.
No.
Already no. Whoever the other option is.
Or Kareem Hunt.
I'd probably go Montgomery just because of the workload.
He's the starter. Yeah.
There's so many pieces that are still going to be fit into this puzzle when it comes to these two.
So you want to switch? I mean,
I hope they get Cam. Chicago gets Cam.
That's what I mean. If they get Cam, then yeah, I'd go Montgomery.
I like that a lot.
Fine, then Kareem Hunt or Phillip Lindsay?
Hunt.
Yeah, I go Hunt too.
Really?
Sorry, Max.
I have very little faith in Lindsey.
I'm getting to that point, but like
they're
going to
draft
believe,
someone no, earlier than people
that.
Think.
He's going to get enough carries.
Take a lot of the a
I've
lot
reached
of the
that
receiving
point.
Workload.
I'm pretty
receiving work, I agree, but I still think Lindsey's going to get 12 to 15 carries.
He should, as he should.
And I think with the way this they're building this offensive line, you're going to have much better holes for him. I think he's going to have a bounce back year.
Yeah,
a
I'll still
year.
Take Hunt, though. Not saying I don't like Lindsey, but just like...
I agree with Hunt.
I'm pretty off the Lindsey board.
Yeah, I am too.
I just don't... I can't buy into Hunt right now with all the other guys on that team. And
that's what I thought
and
last
the
year.
Chubb
he played,
and
he was
like,
okay.
Yeah.
And in a completely incompetent offense with no offensive line. So, we'll see.
Okay.
I take Hunt and his talent.
Deebo Samuel or... John Brown.
John Brown.
Deebo.
John Brown.
Really?
Yeah.
No.
I fucking love
this
John
is a
Brown.
Bad take, Snacks. You're going to regret this take.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
But no, Deebo not. Samuel or Terry McLaurin?
Terry.
Really?
No one likes Terry more than I do.
I love Terry. It's funny Deebo. That you switched so fast from Deebo, though.
Deebo.
I literally
fucking love Deebo. You guys know how much I love Deebo. I'm taking John Brown because he's going to be, I'm foreshadowing. He's going to be one of my guys this year.
Oh, yeah?
John Brown.
Yeah. John Brown.
He didn't have one game under nine fantasy points.
I honestly like Cole Beasley more than John Brown this year.
He didn't have one game. He didn't have one game. John Brown didn't have one game under nine fantasy points.
Did he have any games over 11?
It's like five.
Yeah, like, dude, with Diggs there, there's no way you could like
I
Brown
think
more.
It's even better.
No.
No.
Stop.
All right, how about...
We'll see.
It's
we'll,
Deebo.
We'll see. You got to have both
It's Deebo
takes.
Until
we'll
they
see.
Take... until they use that 13th overall
fucking,
pick
I do,
on,
I do,
on CD
I do love Deebo. I wish we were still doing keepers.
It's Terry. Bro, if Cam Newton goes to Washington, Terry's my first round
Wait,
pick.
Wait, what?
Fantasy
to
league.
Washington?
Dude, wow. Fucking Ron Rivera, Cam Newton? Yeah. Yeah, bro. The connection is there. Wait nah, on it. They're like the third favorite in Vegas right now, too. I'm telling you, it's going to happen.
I see them taking Tua over Cam.
No.
They need a complete fresh new start. They did the same thing with Alex Smith. Don't bring a retreat in like Cam. I don't care about the connections.
Let Dwayne Haskins, let Cam start for six games, build up leadership and culture in the fucking locker room. He gets hurt and then Dwayne's in. It's
yeah,
fine.
That's, there you go.
Adam John Thielen.
Brown. Ron Rivera loves Cam.
I'm nailing my cross to John Brown this
that's
year.
That's a fucking.
Actually, scratch Adam Thielen. Here's the one I want to do. T.Y. Hilton.
I would take Deebo. I thought
I didn't even get to the second guy. T.Y. Hilton or Marquise Brown?
We also got word that Rivers is signing
Rivers
in Indy.
Is in Indy.
Yes.
Yes.
So, let's talk about that real quick. So Rivers signs in Indy 1 year, $25 million.
Whatever.
He's shot.
Oh yeah. But like you have to talk about what this means for T.Y. because T.Y. was great when healthy, and he's always been great when healthy. But like, I mean, where's T.Y. going for you?
I don't really want to look at him yet.
I feel like he hasn't really. He just kind of stays
Everything
where
stays
he is.
The same. T.Y. is where what round pick on your board, and same thing with Marlon Mack.
I mean, T.Y.
I like Mac more than I would like.
Probably a 6-7 round guy, right?
Hilton's not going to last to the
sixth
or seventh round.
Sixth round?
I think he's a
late
round
four,
pick.
Early five.
Yeah.
I feel like he's going to fall this year. I feel like you're not accounting for like Deebo, AJ Brown, all those new guys from last year that are going to be drafted ahead of him this year.
I'm accounting for them.
I don't think you are. I think sixth round, T.Y. Hilton.
Well, what concerns
late
me,
five,
and they are at
5'8".
I said five.
They're different
receivers. Now
you
can't come late,
here, five.
Late five.
They're different receivers, but remember Keenan
Allen
last
year? You went from seventh to fifth.
Early seven to late five.
Oh, Keenan Allen last year was what? Like wide receiver one the first 3 weeks? Yeah. Unbelievable. And then Phillip Rivers completely fell off a cliff.
Yeah, I
how
like
am I gonna
Jack
trust,
Doyle
and
more.
I like Keenan over T.Y., and I love T.Y., but how the fuck am I going to trust anything with T.Y. with an absolutely completely shot Phillip Rivers coming in there.
No, you're right. But I mean, he connected with Mike Williams on a bunch of deep balls. I don't hate Hilton there.
I hate
everyone else in the Colts offense.
I can't do it. I can't do it.
They're a team I'm willing to probably miss out on in fantasy this year and be wrong about. But what was your, you had a T.Y. versus someone else question.
T.Y. Hilton versus Marquise Brown.
I think you have to go T.Y. there. I don't see those two being drafted near each other though.
They are pretty close according to this. Well, they have T.Y. pretty late.
Where are you pulling the ADP from?
Fancy Mojo.
Okay. Those are FFPC drafts. Those are actually like high stakes ones.
Yeah.
I'd probably go T.Y. too.
T.Y. fell.
I would go T.Y. The Ravens have to address how wide receiver.
I was going to say, I'm surprised they didn't really go hard after like Amari Cooper. I thought that would have been a nice,
that would have been
nice
cool.
fit.
I do like Hollywood a lot this year though. He'll be someone
I don't like him.
I do. He'll be someone that
I think he was
Hollywood.
He
or John
came
Brown.
Into the year like her already and everything. Like you're gonna see.
You'll see, bro.
I think Hollywood.
No. You're gonna be a fucking idiot.
I like Hollywood this year. That's pretty much it. I mean, I could keep making up random
nah, fuck
ones,
it. Let's move forward. CBA.
That's I kind of don't want to go home, so let's just keep going.
I gotta go back and move shit in. Okay.
But I don't want to go home. So I want her to go last week.
You're allowed to
stay
here.
Let's do predictions. Cam Newton, where you think he's going?
Oh, so let's see who's wrong on Friday?
Yeah, just like for fun. Fuck it. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to say...
It's going to be Chicago.
That's like the most logical choice.
Chicago, but I'll go Washington just for fun.
Yeah, fuck you. Shit.
I told you that.
I know, and I like it. You said Chicago. I was going to steal it. I'm going to go Miami. I think they're going to do some weird shit.
Stop that.
Miami. All right. They need a quarterback.
Then I'll go Chicago because I do think that's kind of likely. I feel like that makes the most sense.
New York Giants.
What about him?
Can?
You heard every word.
Honestly, I'm not even kidding. Like, I was serious before when I said this, that I think Elway, I wouldn't be shocked if he, like, all of a sudden.
I would be stunned.
Like, gives up a fourth round pick, trades
for
Cam.
Whoa.
Because they're going to cut him if they can't get a fourth.
What about Cam to the Patriots?
I just don't see that too. Bell.
No way they want him.
He doesn't fit their system.
Please.
Andy Dalton's going to the Patriots. Or Josh Rosen.
I think so too. No, I think Dalton's a perfect fit.
All right, so CBA.
Yeah, Animal.
No, that's all you, buddy.
7 playoff teams. What do you guys think of that? A lot of new, they voted. Which
Hold on. I don't care. There's,
No.
You can't give us the floor and then tell us the floor. Right, exactly. Either lead it or don't.
Exactly. We've been going on a while, so let's just get right to the crux of it.
Cunt.
500 players didn't vote in a very tight very tight race.
Yeah, lazy fucks.
That is awful.
Yeah.
For fantasy, I think the biggest implication is the fact
that... I wanted to say that because that really pisses me off. If you don't vote, you shouldn't fucking bitch about anything.
I think a couple things come away from this. The fact that they're letting an extra team into the playoffs, but the number 2 seed does no longer get a bye.
Love that.
It's great because more teams are going to be competing down the
stretch. Week 17, they're going to be, at least for this year.
Yeah, week 17. So, and even the ones that lock up buys like week 16.
They're going to play.
Change much for fantasy, though, as like our schedule stays the same. Everything's the same for us.
Well, just that. Just if you're someone in the championship and you had to worry about a team that was, I mean, the players that are on really good teams usually get the buys, and those guys are also the ones that get your fantasy championship. Teams,
yeah. Yep.
So if so facto, I'm your fucking boss and you're fired.
Love that movie.
What else is new?
fantasy standpoint, but when you get to 2021, aren't they going to...
That's the earliest that they can make that happen. It doesn't mean it's a thing, though.
I mean,
that's, I think it's a reason of something to talk about.
I was just going to say, like, me...
I think that's crazy.
Me personally, I hate it.
I know
think this is terrible, and it's stupid, and it ruins so much
the 17th game?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm with you. I don't like it.
Terrible.
Yeah, well, it's going to end up happening because it's going to put a fuckload of money into the owner's pocket.
Now, all right, so maybe deviating away from fantasy a little bit to end the show. For that 7th playoff team, I mean, figure we got to like it, right? For the teams we root for?
Sure.
You like it like that?
My team is that team.
You like it like that.
Do you like it overall? I kind of like it.
I don't.
Yeah. I do.
It keeps the league more competitive.
No, it's watering it down.
In an already competitive league where you never know what's going to happen.
I like it.
No, you're watering it down.
I like that because the NFL season, you play 16 games.
That's it, yeah.
You get one unlucky break or something, you're out of the playoffs.
Yeah,
but this opens up a little bit more than fucking that.
Right,
whereas like the NBA,
it gives you a little bit more leeway.
Over the long run, like your team will be exposed for who they are.
You can go on a 15-game losing streak in the NBA and still be okay.
Right. So I like it opening up because there's always like one team or two teams that got fucking snubbed out of playoffs for one bullshit call or one bullshit play or something like that. This opens that back up.
I've seen the past just like on a Giants fan standpoint. Twice since I've been alive, they've been 10-6, missed the playoffs.
Yeah, like I can't stand that shit. Especially when a 10-6 team misses the playoffs.
And
like
the other conference,
8-9 that's annoying.
Right.
I like how...
What don't you like about it? Like, do you have a reason why you don't like it or other than like...
Just if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Yeah. Well, other than like old Republican like George.
No, that's part of like... I don't think it's broken. I don't think you need to change anything.
I can understand that because the playoffs are still electric as always. But
my biggest problem with this whole CBA is the extra game. I don't care necessarily so much about the extra playoff team.
Like, I'm annoyed about the extra game.
You're going to fuck up records that have been on for however many years now. Like,
I don't like that either.
Like season records, all these, like everything's skewed now. Everything's fucked. It's going to be
so different. Yeah, they're going to put new incentives into the contracts and shit. Do you think they put an extra bye week?
Yeah, they have to.
Well, that's the thing. They wanted to do this without doing an extra bye week, which is the problem.
That's a problem.
Well, and it's...
Well, they'll take out a preseason game as well.
And it's also funny that...
Who cares?
No, you're right. I'm just saying.
I think those 4 preseason games are crucial to my team. I want that extra preseason game.
That's why.
Wait, so is that a fact? That there's no second buy? Is that a fact?
They have to figure out how they're going to put it in the schedule.
I don't think that's a complete
fact. They have to have that in the contract.
Because when that initially came out, they suggested 2 buys.
It has to be 2.
There has to be.
If you're going
to
put an extra
game. Think about it. And it, like, The NBA is taking off, and I've read articles. I think it was on The Ringer and one on The Athletic, where the NBA has been wanting to test out like a 2-week break in the middle of the season anyway. That. So it's like, why not get your best players ready for the playoffs and stuff like that? So just keep 16 games, have 2 bye weeks, keep people fresh, keep players
that
fresh.
That shit's gonna change the entire landscape of fantasy.
Crazy
how you do your strategy. Crazy. And shit. I can't
think off the top of my head. They want to go to an 18 game season. And I think that's when they would initiate the extra bye.
So in the CBA talks, is it saying like that they're gonna? I thought it was
they
just
can't
that
go
in
to 18 games
is the
until
earliest, and 17.
Yeah, is the 2031 is the earliest for 18 games.
Okay, so 2031.
Yeah,
for 18 games.
Yeah,
we'll still be doing Fade the Public.
I mean, yeah.
What do you think this podcast is gonna look like in 2031?
We'll be robots. We'll be dead. Like Plankton's wife. Well,
us three will die from Corona, without a doubt.
I don't know that 2030. Like, why? It's like
it's just every 10 years.
It's just some
news.
Stupid.
All right.
Well, and like I know a big thing for this deal too was like training camp and stuff like players.
Are they
like
allowed to hit each other again?
No, they're not now. The padded practices, they don't want them. They want
less
of those.
They don't realize that's why so many injuries happen.
Yes, I know, because your body's not used to. You have to get fucking beat up and get used to it.
You need to practice
and then,
what you're doing in a game. And
I know.
They don't do
that's
that.
Why these guys get hit and then they go down. They crumble. Facts. So that's a big problem. I just don't like anything of the CBA. I think it softens the league. It softens the people in the league. Like the only thing I like about it is the marijuana testing. Like we don't need who cares.
I wouldn't
let these guys smoke all the weed
they
want.
I wouldn't go all that far. I do like the 7 playoff teams and the 1 bye. I think it makes every game even that much more prudent.
I don't think there's a good argument against that.
I don't either. I really don't. Like what? They're all going to be trying harder.
Yeah.
I almost think it alleviates tanking a little bit, because if you're 4-7. 3-6, your season's not over.
Well, yeah.
At all.
Yeah. I think it'll make it makes the landscape more competitive.
Absolutely.
Makes teams
and in football,
compete till the end.
And in football, we've seen crazy shit happen. Crazy shit. Peyton Manning's noodle arm winning a Super Bowl with Denver. The Giants doing what they like. Just every year, it's crazy. So why not expand it a little bit more?
Yeah.
I like it a lot. And it makes that bye even that much more important. So
the only problem I have is I think the players didn't get enough. They could have easily bargained for more.
They should have came and voted.
Well, that too, but they settled for like the marijuana testing thing. It's not even it's violations of law for marijuana will not result in suspension. But
I thought that was just during this, or that is that the
and there's stimulants and diarrhea. Like they still can get fucked basically, but it's not.
There's
for,
always language in there that's going to be deceiving.
Yeah, I don't think we should speak on that just because that. I have no idea have no what idea. The fuck's actually going on they give us the big headline topics of it, and then there's so much underlying print that we have no idea.
Nothing that we'll understand anyway. So
yeah, so if you test positive, your test gets reviewed by a board of jointly appointed medical professionals to determine whether you need any kind of treatment. So
they're gonna bag them all.
Yeah,
every time they're gonna bag them.
Who knows how it'll actually work, but. Like you said, the 500 players is crucial.
What was the vote? It was under 300, wasn't it?
And then the whole thing, they're expanding rosters too, the 55-man roster. But you still
I like that too.
But you still have to cut down to 53.
But you're still adding 5 guys. There's 48-man active roster on game day. So you'd be adding 5 guys, which is that could be essential.
Teams more flexibility.
Am I reading that?
I'm reading it right now here. Yeah, more jobs. That's another way the players benefit. The game day active roster will increase from 46 to 48 players, although one of the extra players must be an offensive lineman, which will give teams more flexibility to have 3 extra linemen. Practice squads expand from 10 players to 12 in 2020. In 2021, that goes to 14 in 2022.
Wait, hold on. What? I don't think this is that bad. You're giving 2 extra practice squad spots to players who have a chance to jump up. You're giving more opportunity. Another playoff team. What's so bad about this deal? Before we sign off, that you said you don't like it so much.
No, I'm more against the extra game. That's the biggest problem with me. The extra game.
Yeah, but that's not even. That's still years out, probably.
I can't picture them doing it next year either. I think they're going to see how this works with 7, and I think it's going to work good. Why change it? But they did vote on it, I guess, so I don't know when that comes. But other than that, what else is wrong with the CBA? I feel like it's a pretty good deal. I mean, what do I know? I talk about it.
I don't
play
know.
It, so.
I have no idea. I haven't looked into the legal shit. I only look at it from a fantasy perspective. Yeah. That is our take on it from Fantasy Landscape Peoples. I hope some of that made sense. I hope you enjoyed this episode. We ran for over an hour. Well, first, 30 minutes, it wasn't ridiculous.
It wasn't like energy driven and whatnot. I think we played up to the mood of our country.
We're just kind of going with the flow and, you know, trying to
provide you some normalization and some stuff to talk about.
So yeah, with all the information that we have to date. Remember, we are filming this on Tuesday. Yeah. So
Tuesday, 6 p.m., 5 to 6 p.m.
Don't be trashing us that we, you know, got a bunch of shit wrong.
We're all quarantined, so ask some questions. I think
the PGA Tour has been postponed through May 10th.
Son of a bitch.
Fuck. Well, the Masters was canceled. So.
Everything is canceled.
Everything is canceled. This show is fucking canceled now. We'll see you next week on Fade the Public. Thank you for joining us. We love you. Hit that thumbs up button if you enjoyed. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. 5-star rating and review.